Good morning, children. Assalamu alaikum. How are you all? Welcome back to our online class. Today is 6th January 2021, Wednesday. Yes, children, we were in the lesson Respiration and Organisms. Part 2 we'll do today. Gases in our breath. We breathe, isn't it? What are the gases present? Which gases we breathe in, we breathe out, and all the other gases which we take in for respiration. The air we breathe in, there are three vital, important, vital means respiratory gases and the red blood cells, oxygen, nitric oxide, and carbon dioxide. Inhaled and exhaled air. Gas which is inhaled, taken in, is oxygen 91%, exhaled, given out 16%. Carbon dioxide 0.04% is taken in and 4% is given out. Nitrogen 79% is given taken inside the body and same 79% is given out of the body, nitrogen. The most abundant naturally occurring gas is the nitrogen N2, which makes about 78% of air. Oxygen 2% is the most important, isn't it, gas abundant, about 21%. The inert gas argon is the third most abundant gas. A high carbon dioxide level can cause rapid breathing and confusion. Some people have respiratory failure, may become very sleepy, loss of consciousness. It happens. These are the symptoms. They also may have arrhythmia, irregular heartbeat. You may have these symptoms. If your brain and heart are not getting enough, oxygen. Nitrous oxide. It is a safe and effective sedative agent that is mixed with oxygen and inhaled through a small mask that fits over your nose to help you relax. Nitrous oxide is sometimes called laughing gas. Is one option your dentist may offer to help to make you comfortable during certain procedures. Got it? Thus we'll see the picture how animals are breathing. Just like human beings, even animals breathe. Breathing is a process of inhaling oxygen and exhaling carbon dioxide. Inhale, again I'm telling you, inhale means take in, exhale means give out. Few organisms have lungs in their chest cavity which helps them to breathe. Skin, gills and are respiratory organs. Even in aquatic animals, organisms like fishes, lungs are respiratory organs. In the land animals such as lizards, dogs, frogs, etc. Skin is respiratory organ in earthworm, amphibians and frog. Got it? Different respiratory organs are there in different animals for breathing. Tracheal systems. Respiration that occurs using a variety of respiratory organs in different animals including skin, gills and trachea. Got it, man? Now you'll see in the diagram. Breathing system in fishes, aquatic animals, gills with the how we breathe with the help of gills. Different earthworm and all, skin. We see in the picture, so many pictures. we understand what are the respiratory organs. How do we breathe? What happens when animals breathe? When animals breathe in, the air is pumped into the organs of respiratory system, that is the lungs. Delicate blood vessels extract the oxygen from the air. All there is left then is the same carbon dioxide, which is transported out of the tissue and cells when breathing out. That is why they are called slimy creatures. The reason behind their moist skin is that earthworm's breathing organ is the skin. Got it? Air can easily pass through the skin of earthworm. They breathe through their skin. Air dissolves on the mucus of their skin, so they must stay moist to breathe. If worms dry out, they suffocate. As the fresh air is taken in through the skin, oxygen is drawn into the worm's circulatory system and the worm's heart pump and the oxygenated system to the head area. As we see in the diagram, earthworm, oxygen is there, carbon dioxide is there. In the respiration in next is respiration in plants. Simplified, we breathe in oxygen and carbon dioxide, we give out. Is it clear? Plants do the opposite. They open the stomata on the leaves. They allow the carbon dioxide to enter the plant. However, water vapor can escape. So, regulation of stomata is crucial for maintaining the plant water status. Got it? Respiration in leaves. The leaves of the plants have tiny pores on their surface called the stomata. The exchange of gases in the leaves during respiration takes place through stomata. This happens as follows. Oxygen from the air enters into the leaf through the stomata and reaches all the cells by the procession of diffusion. Respiration is essential for the growth and maintenance of all plant tissues and plays an important role in the carbon balance of individual cells, whole plants and ecosystems, as well as in global. What happens in respiration in sprouts? After about a week, you will find that lime water turns white in the test tube with sprouts. You know the moong sprouts, rajma, chickpeas and all other sprouts which we eat, which we must eat, but hardly we all eat, isn't it? It's very nutritious, proteinaceous. Lime water turns white when carbon dioxide is dissolved in the lime water. It means that the carbon dioxide gas was produced by the sprouts. Carbon dioxide is produced by breathing of sprouts, which take oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide. Germinating seeds are used in the experiment of the release of carbon dioxide during the respiration because they respire a lot more than a plant that has already grown. A new plant will require more energy and oxygen to get started. Germinating seeds are active as well, as we see in the figure of it. We'll conclude the lesson with the homework. What are the gases which we inhale every day? How do cockroaches and earthworm breathe? Got it, children? Submit the homeworks by 5 in the evening. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum. See you in next class.